Welcome to Jim Reynolds Outdoors, and today I have on the line for you a very special guest, Dixie Fetcho from Twin Creek Mines, Crystal Mines, down in Mount Ida, Arkansas. And she was so gracious to let us come down and dig for some crystals during the World Championship Crystal Mine Dig, and tell our listeners what they have to do to come and dig at your mine, Dixie.
They just have to come on out. It's on Collier Springs Road. We're open every single day but Christmas, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. You don't need reservations or anything. You just come on out, and I have nice hostesses to meet you.
Well, I know Tracy was one of the hostesses with the Mostesses. And
she was.
We had a great time talking, and I know she graduated there from Mount Ida, Arkansas, and we just had a great little visit as well. And I know you got some other helpers there too. Would you like to recognize them as well?
Yes, sir. Miss Lisa, she works on Wednesdays and Thursdays, and on the weekends we have little Miss Brittany.
Yes, Brittany showed us a good time. As a matter of fact, Brittany was taking pictures of us, and we didn't even know it.
Like that.
Yeah, she's slick. Well, you know, one of the things that I found interesting as we were digging for crystals at your mine was the sand content in the clay and the dirt, and it wasn't really clumpy. It was just real loose, and you could really dig through it and find the crystals fairly easily.
Right. Sandstone is soft after it's beat about 1,000 times.
Well, I know your husband, Bobby, you know, he was the one responsible for, you know, digging it out of the hillside and putting it there where everybody could kind of dig through it. How did you and Bobby get hooked up as far as crystal mining? And tell us a little bit of that story.
Actually, I met Bobby in Hot Springs, and I didn't know what a crystal miner was. But he brought me out to his parents' mine. His parents, Jim and Kathy Fetcho, had the very first claim here in Montgomery County for crystals in 63. And so they've been in it all their lives. He brought me out to the mine that they're mining then, which is Bear Mountain Mine. And he dug me a big cluster. And, well, I learned to dig. And 3 years later, we took a point off that cluster and made my engagement ring.
Wow. That's pretty exciting.
Very. And we were married just June 13th of this year.
Well, wow, that's a neat story, Dixie. I'm glad you shared that with our listeners. Now, you know, to come down to the crystal mine, down to your mine, tell our listeners what they need to do and what they need to expect and how much you charge and how to get a hold of you.
Okay, it's $25 all day long for adults. We don't charge you anything extra for what you find. You pay to come in and dig, and you can carry out whatever you can carry out. You need, like, small garden tools, or else we have them very reasonable, $3 at the mine, a bucket. And if you want to dig in our wall area, you'll need a digging bar, a rock hammer, chisel,
yeah,
things like that.
I actually saw some of those guys.
Open up pocket.
Yeah, I saw some of those guys actually with the pry bars and the chisels, and they were finding some pretty nice crystals as well.
Oh, yes, sir, they do. Our mine, we allow people to come in there and actually dig their own pockets. We blast and scrape the walls just like we do in our own commercial mine. We don't have a tailings pile, but we do have a blast-off pile, which has full points and clusters and all that stuff in it.
Yeah. Well, you know, it didn't even, you know, it sprinkled on us a little bit while we were there, but not bad. How did Saturday go? Tell me, you know, we came in on Friday. How did Saturday go?
Oh, boy. It was hurry, hurry, hurry dig. I had the children's dig. Twin Creek Mine Office sponsors the children's dig. And when we blast the mountain, we take the first blast off, which I call glitter because that's what it looks like. And I'll take your bucket of that and put it up for the year. Mm-hmm. And this year we had 10 buckets saved up of the glitter, and we poured it in a trailer, and Bobby put a track hose scoop of dirt on top of it for him, and I drove it out there to the fairgrounds, and all of the children, sixth grade or under, got to go in there and mine their own crystals.
Well, that's exciting. I know you were telling me about the junior division and a little girl. Tell us a little bit about that as far as the junior competition.
Well, they just added a junior competition this year because we had a few young miners last year at our mine that worked really, really hard, but of course they can't compete with the old-time miners.
The experienced ones,
and so we wanted an extra place for them. And this year I was really excited to see the kids come out and dig, And the little girl that we had down in our bottom mine, we had two mines open, but the little girl that we had in our bottom mine where you were at, her name was Kinley from Missouri, and she was hard rock mining. I mean, she had a chisel and the whole nine. I was like, go girl.
Well, it sounds...
She also took third place in the competition.
Wow, so she had a good time. And I noticed a lot, you know, if you watch the video that we have on our Good Morning Greenwood site of the Crystal Dig, I noticed that there were a lot of people there in an area that you had just opened up. Is that right?
Yes, that we had so many people last year at the World Championship, we had to go open up a different mine for them this year.
Well, I know you had a good time, and I know you were coming around and giving water bottles to everybody, and just the hospitality was really great, and I appreciate that.
Oh, thank you very much. We appreciate what we return. People come out here, and they just smile and have a good time and spend the whole day with their family. And you can also bring out a picnic lunch or whatever, because we have picnic tables out there that are shaded. Our mine is not in a pit. Like most mines, it's on the side of a mountain.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have a breeze coming through there constantly.
Yeah, and I noticed people. Yeah, there were people there from all over the country as well.
Yes, sir. All over the world we have them. As a matter of fact, we had a Brazilian digger this weekend.
Well, I had a guy right beside me, and he was from Hawaii. And
right.
Yeah, his name was Michael Running Bear, and he lived in Hawaii, but I believe he had some ancestry from up in the Alaska area as well.
Yes, sir, I believe you're right.
Yeah, so, you know, it was really neat getting to meet the people from all over the country. Well, you know, we had a great time. Like I said, you talk about glitter pile. We brought home some glitter as well, and your husband did, you know, he was a great hostess as well. And I don't know if he wants me to call him a hostess, but that's what he was. And he looks like a jack of all trades. I mean, he was out there.
Definitely.
And, yeah, he was out there, and you were out there giving water, and he was getting the equipment ready for the dig to help for the next day. And so, anyway, we really appreciate you. And everybody was very, very kind to us. And we look forward to coming back again. And I hope I get to bring my family as well.
Well, tell me, Jim, can y'all dig it?
We sure can dig it. And Dixie, we thank you so much for being on Jim Reynolds Outdoors. You know, that's part of our mission, is getting into the outdoors all over the state of Arkansas and Oklahoma especially, but all throughout the country as well. And thank you once again, Dixie.
Thank you.
That was great talking to Dixie. I enjoyed it. We had a great time down there, and it was a beautiful day. It wasn't too hot, and we dug a lot and found some crystals and had a good time. So anyway, stay tuned to Jim Reynolds Outdoors. We'll be back in just a moment.